Good morning, and welcome to St. John the Baptist Cathedral Basilica Parish. We welcome all of you present and those joining us through live stream for the Mass of Christian Burial for Maureen Doyle. We ask that all, during the ongoing pandemic, to continue to use hand sanitizers and to maintain a distance of 2 meters, and the wearing of masks is strongly encouraged.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
I'm gathered here today with Maureen's family, with John and Michelle, and Edward and Joanne, Eileen and Robert and Gregory and Marie and Michael and Kathleen. I hope I got them all. And all their families, and especially the grandchildren, and especially them. And all our friends. And parishioners from Pius X especially. Welcome Father Joe Shook, representing the Jesuits and Pius X Parish today. Today at the beginning after funeral mass, we reflect on Maureen's call on baptism. In the baptism, on the day of her baptism, she was welcomed into the church and given new life in Christ and clothed with the garment of salvation. Today we greet now the body of our sister Maureen. We surround her with the church's prayer. We commend our sister Maureen to the mercy of God. And we pray that the promises made to her in baptism will be fulfilled.
Our gathering chant, 520 in your Catholic Book of Worship, "Here I am, Lord."
Of night, I will make darkness bright, who will bear my light to them? Whom shall I send? Here I am, Lord. Is it I, Lord? I have heard of you calling in the night. I will go, turn away. I will break their hearts of stone, give them hearts for love alone. I will speak my word to them. Whom shall I send? Here I am, is it I, Lord? I have heard you calling in the night. I will go, Lord, if you lead me. I will hold your people in my heart.
Let us pray. God of our ancestors in faith, by the covenant made in Mount Sinai, you taught your people to strengthen the bonds of family through faith, honor, and love. Look kindly upon Maureen, a mother, who sought to bind her children and grandchildren to you. Bring her one day to our heavenly home, where the saints dwell in blessedness and peace. And we ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Please be seated for our readings, and I call forward Gregory for the first reading.
A reading from the book of Proverbs. A valiant woman, who can find her? She is far more precious than jewels. Her community trusts in her, and they will have no lack of gain. She does them good and not harm all the days of her life. She girds herself with strength and makes her arms strong. Her lamp does not go out at night. She opens her hand to the poor and reaches out her hands to the needy. Strength and dignity are her clothing, and she laughs at the time to come. She opens her mouth with wisdom, and the teaching of kindness is on her tongue. She looks well to the ways of her household and does not eat the bread of idleness. Many women have done excellently, but you surpass them all. Charm is deceitful, and beauty is vain. But the woman who fears the Lord is to be praised. Give her a share of the fruits of her hands, and let her work praise her in the city gates. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The responsorial psalm is number 23, "The Lord is my shepherd, and nothing do I want," number 607.
Second reading.
A A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Colossians. Brothers and sisters, as God's chosen ones, holy and beloved, clothe yourselves with compassion, kindness, humility, meekness, and patience. Bear with one another, and if anyone has a complaint against you, forgive each other. Just as the Lord has forgiven you, so you must also forgive. Above all, clothe yourselves with love, which binds everything together in perfect harmony. And let the peace of Christ rule in your hearts, to which indeed you were called in the one body, and be thankful. Let the word of Christ dwell in you richly. Teach and admonish one another in all wisdom, and with gratitudes in your hearts, sing psalms, hymns, and spiritual songs of God. And whatever you do, in word or deed, do everything in the name of Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God the Father through him. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. When Jesus saw the crowds, he went up the mountain, and after he sat down, his disciples came to him. Then he began to speak and taught them, saying, "Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the earth. And blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be filled. Blessed are the merciful, for they will receive mercy. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they will see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called children of God. And blessed are those who are persecuted for righteousness' sake, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. And blessed are you when people revile you and persecute you and utter all kinds of evil against you falsely on my account. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward is great in heaven." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Please be seated. We gather and journey today in sorrow, but also in faith and with hope with Maureen Doyle's family, her 10 children and her 11 grandchildren, who affectionately called her Mum, I heard last night. And we gather today in this historic place to thank God for the life of this wonderful Christian lady. We recognize the pain of loss for the family, and I certainly felt that pain at the vigil last night. But in it all, in this season of thanksgiving, there was a wonderful spirit of gratitude to God for the gift of Maureen in their lives, and gratitude to Maureen for all she was and will always be to them, a powerful presence of love, devotion, and dedication to our family. To them, she was the valiant woman of the Proverbs, loved by her family and community, strong in character, generous to the needy, a woman of God, who certainly her lamp was lit many times late in the night, as it says in Proverbs. On behalf of the Basilica Parish community and the St. Pius X Parish community, where Maureen and her family worshiped for 60 years, and the Jesuits represented here by Father Joe, we extend to all the family our prayers for Maureen and prayers for your consolation as you mourn her passing from this life to the glory of eternal life. At the vigil last night, it was very clear to me that for Maureen, family was the focus of her life. In our massive Christian burial for Maureen, we reflect that, first of all, God calls us in baptism and chooses each of us for a particular mission, vocation in life. In baptism, Maureen was made a child of God, a member of the Catholic Christian community, a temple of the Holy Spirit, and she began her journey of faith, a journey that would lead her to her true homeland, heaven. As Christians, we believe that life is changed, not ended with death, and we have the promise of the resurrection to new life. So that gives us great hope that one day we shall enjoy Maureen's friendship again. Maureen fulfilled her baptismal calling, her vocation to family life so well. First of all, as a devoted daughter to her parents, Frank and Lillian, loving wife to her husband of 44 years, John G. Doyle, loyal sister and loving mom to her grandchildren who adored her and her children as well. All of you were so blessed by God to have the gift of Maureen in your lives. Each day of her life, Maureen opened that gift of herself, laid down her life in love and sacrifice for you and for others. I chose the reading from the Beatitudes for the funeral mass because I think it so captures the attitudes that she has. And I thank many members, especially the grandchildren, for submitting pieces for this homily today. In the Beatitudes, Jesus sits with his friends and relatives and teaches us the real meaning of life and what has the highest value. Blessedness is all about, not about power, not about wealth. Now, according to Jesus, blessedness is about an attitude of gentleness, compassion and mercy, forgiveness and gratitude, all descriptions of love that St. Paul also spoke about in the second reading to the Colossians, attitudes that Maureen certainly had. If we want to know what the heart of God is like, we have to look no farther than the Beatitudes. Maureen clearly embraced Jesus' path of blessedness. Blessed are you, Maureen, because you were poor in spirit. You were a woman of great faith. You were dedicated to your parish Pius X. And as Heather said, you were a fixture at Sunday Mass at Pius. The Doyle family took up an entire pew. You passed on that gift of your faith tradition. They spoke about that last night, your duty as a Christian parent to educate your children in the faith and your grandchildren as well. Your faith was one of action. You put your faith into practice by your kind and loving deeds for others each day. You didn't make material possessions the most important treasure in your life. God was, your family was, the people you loved were. You used your God-given talents and gifts to serve them and others. You know, faith helps us to carry our crosses courageously. During the dark days of the deaths of your husband, Maureen, your parents, your siblings, you know, even now your parish church, your faith helped you carry the crosses courageously with the loving care of your family and friends. Even when you were sick, you always were more concerned about the needs of others. You were truly selfless in your love. Blessed are you, Maureen, you mourned, you will be comforted. Heather said to me about you spent your life taking care of your children and your grandchildren. All of it was done with patience and caring. Even last night we talked about adult children who were sick would often be told to come and stay there with her and you would nurse them back to health. In your dealings with others, you always showed compassion and care to those especially going through difficult times in their lives. I was told that those who lost loved ones, you gave a ham. You did something, you cooked something for them and brought it to them. Little gestures of love and kindness. To those who had made bad choices in life or lost their way, you always were there to open your arms and pick them up. Blessed are you, Maureen, because you were meek, gentle of heart, you will inherit the earth. You're a woman of compassion and kindness of heart with a very special gift for hospitality and welcoming, for sure. You were the one who was hospitable and welcomed everyone into your home, and at times there were many more from the highways and byways there than your own children and grandchildren. Many spoke last night of you being an amazing organizer for family gatherings, the popular Sunday dinners with your family and extended people, because you love bringing people together. Blessed are you, Maureen, because you were merciful to others. You will receive mercy yourself. When we forgive, we transform and recreate. Heather said to me she took care, you took care of all her children and grandchildren with patience. If you were a friend of the family, you were her friend. I heard that when Maureen died, that was an interesting story, the rugby game stopped, and that was going on. I had a moment of silence for her as she used to wash all the rugby jerseys for Michael's team, I heard. That goes to show even with everything else she had to do, she did that rather unpleasant job joyfully. Maureen, you were sensitive to the needs of others. You were not judgmental. You were kind and caring to those who were hurting. The Lord will show your mercy. Blessed are you, Maureen, for you were pure of heart. You shall see God. Your family, your life was your life, and you loved them, and they loved you back. You showed unconditional love to them. You were constantly at all the events in the life of your children and grandchildren. I can attest to that because while I was at St. Bond's, you came to every event possible in which your grandchildren participated. So much so, we were going to charge you tuition as a mature student. You were there so much. But you could see and feel your love and admiration and support for what your grandchildren were accomplishing, and you were so proud of them, they loved you back. Even if they were involved in various sports around town, you would get, I was told last night, you get in several games in one day. You would take off and do 50 minutes of this one and that one and this one and that one, just to show your presence to your family. And you were an athlete too as well. You love sports. Your prowess showed recently at lawn bowling, where you represented Newfoundland in various national events. Some of the grandchildren wrote me a few little lines I'd like to say about what this means for them. Heather wrote that being your granddaughter has been her greatest privilege. How lucky, she said, was I to have such a role model, loving, hilarious, giving, and capable of making us all feel important and valued. You made every moment special and taught me unconditional love. Maria, her sister, another grandchild, added, it's hard to put into words how lucky I felt to be your granddaughter from every single lunch we shared for 18 years, Sunday dinners and birthdays, and traveling all across the country to watch me play basketball. Seeing you in the stands was truly so special. Chris, another grandchild, told me that you were the sweetest, most compassionate, loving woman who cared about your grandchildren like they were your own. He said, anytime I had a sporting or school event, I knew without a doubt that I would look over and see Mom's beautiful face smiling at me. You were always so proud of us and encouraged us in whatever endeavors we were taking on at the time. Mariam wrote, Mom spoiled us grandchildren, was always interested in what we were up to. I remember our Sunday morning chats after Mass with family coming to visit you. You had a great sense of humor and was always quick with a comeback. I know that for sure. Even though you were running the house and keeping track of everyone, you had time to see what I was up to. Blessed are you, Maureen. You were a peacemaker, and you will always be called a child of God. Well, having 10 children, you have to be a peacemaker. You made everything and everyone around you feel better. Last night, the family said you always uplifted others. You made them feel important and valued. Everyone was welcome and had an open door and a full table. You built a close family, and you were able to celebrate the uniqueness of every person and see them as God's gift to you and others. And you had that gift of bringing people together and sought to bring peace and reconciliation and to solve bad situations peacefully, always treating people with respect and dignity, by the way. Blessed are you, Maureen, for your hunger and thirst for what is right, and you will be satisfied. You know, Heather mentioned that you studied commerce as a degree in St. Francis Xavier at a time that was a trailblazing for women. And so she said she appreciated that she set an example, or you set an example that women could do anything. Maureen, you used this knowledge to be partner in business with your husband, John, and with all that family and organization going on, You could have easily have been premier or prime minister, easily. Heather told me about your lifelong friend Marg, who wrote on her graduation picture from St. Evex, Maureen, a better friend I never knew, good, kind, noble, and true. So we can take comfort, reflecting on all that today, knowing that Maureen daily lived the Beatitudes of Jesus Christ. Let us comfort one another then today in the faith of the risen Jesus, so that in your sorrow you will find hope in the God of mercy, gentleness, and peace in which Maureen put her trust and hope. Those we love are never really lost to us, are they? We feel them in so many special ways, through friends they always cared about and dreams they left behind, in beauty that they added to our days. In words of wisdom we shall carry with us, and memories that will never be gone. Those we love will never be lost to us, for everywhere their special love lives on. As we see Maureen end her life's journey and journey back to the Father, know that her love for you, our family and friends, and her love for will be continuous beyond death. Love never ends, as St. Paul says. We commend you, Maureen, to the loving mercy of God, and may you have peace on your journey home to the Father, and may Jesus, the Good Shepherd, carefully and lovingly carry you to your rest, where you will reunite with all your loved ones who have gone before you. I call forward now the intercessors for our prayers of intercession to go to that microphone there. Brothers and sisters, we'd ask everybody to stand, please, for our prayers of intercession. Brothers and sisters, Jesus Christ is risen from the dead and sits at the right hand of the Father, where he intercedes for his church. Confident that God hears the voices of those who trust in the Lord Jesus, we join our prayers to his.
After each prayer, please respond, hear our prayer.
Hear our prayer.
For Mum Mum, who in baptism was given the promise of eternal life, may she now be in the company of the angels and saints in heaven. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Maureen was nourished with the table of the Savior. May she be welcomed into the heavenly banquet. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
For the deceased members of the Hogan and Doyle families, especially John, our grandpop, and for all those who have fallen asleep in the hope of resurrection, may they be welcomed into the loving arms of their Father. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
For all the children and grandchildren of Mum Mum, may they be comforted by the precious memories and gestures of love and tenderness shared. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
For all who knew and loved Mum Mum, may they be inspired by her example of love, kindness, and generosity. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
For all of us gathered here to worship in faith, may we be reunited together again in God's kingdom. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer. Lord God, giver of peace and healer of souls, hear the prayers of the Redeemer Jesus Christ and the voices of your people, whose lives were purchased by the blood of the Lamb. Forgive the sins of all who sleep in Christ and grant them a place in the kingdom. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Invite those who are bringing up the gifts for the offertory procession.
Make me a channel of your peace. Where there is hatred, let me bring your love. channel of your peace. Where there's despair in life, let me bring hope. Where there is darkness, only light. And where there's sadness,
pray, my sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice from your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Let us pray. Look favorably on our offerings, O Lord, so that your departed servant Maureen may be taken up into glory with your Son, in whose great mystery of love we are all united through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. So with all the angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
And therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you.
Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Peter, our bishop, and all the clergy. Remember your servant Maureen, whom you have called today from this world to yourself. Grant that she, who was united with your son in a death like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection.
Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Pray with confidence to our Heavenly Father in the words that Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming again of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, I said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And we share that peace of Christ now with one another. Peace be with you.
Lamb of God, you take
Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
For the reception of Holy Communion, we ask that we please begin from side sections, maintain a 2-meter distance in the communion line, sanitize your hands before receiving Holy Communion, and to be seated until the ushers give you the indication to move. Thank you. Communion Christ, hymn number 603, Gift of Finest Wheat.
Christ, Body of Christ.
Amen.
Body of Christ.
You satisfy the hungry heart with gift of finest wheat. Come, give to us, O saving. The bread.
Please stand now and let us pray. Lord God, who left us in the sacrament of his body food for the journey, mercifully grant that strengthened by it our sister Maureen may come to the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen.
Amen.
We'll ask the candles and the cross to come forward.
My brothers and sisters, before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our sister. May our farewell express our affection for her. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet her again when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself. In baptism, Maureen shared in the death and resurrection of Christ. May she be welcomed into the glory of eternal life. As a sign of respect for our sister Maureen, we let this incense rise to God, who has called her to share in his glory. Into your hands, Father of Mercy, we commend our sister Maureen in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, she will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings you have bestowed upon Maureen in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful God, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant, and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith until we all meet in Christ and are with you and with our sister forever.
Amen.
Trying to tag team here. On behalf of the family, I'd like to thank all of you for your presence here today. It's a great sign of comfort and consolation for them, to Father Joe and Father John here, representing the Jesuit community, Pius X as well. We thank all of you for your presence here today. To thank Anne, beautiful singing Anne, Patty Fowler, the organ up there, and Dominic Green, violinist. All those who have prepared this, I'd like to thank the grandchildren for their efforts on this, and certainly all those who prepared and planned it, Gregory especially, leading it. So thank all of you for all the work that you did. And I think there is a reception being held at 26 Carpathian. If I had to say the wrong address, it would have been a big surprise. So 26 Carpathian Road after the burial. So. Dear friends, may every mark of affection, every gesture of friendship that you give to others be a sign of God's peace for you. And now in peace, we take our sister Maureen to her place of final rest. May Almighty God bless all of us. In the name of the Father, Son, Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen. Our sending forth hymn today, Sing with All the Saints in Glory, number 406.
Shall stand.